My name is Angel, and welcome back to my channel for episode 6, day 8. Yes, 8. 8 days left till Halloween. Halloween, Halloween. Now, we've gone over quite a few things, from tragedies to Halloween pranks to werewolf trials, but today we're going to be going over some of the real life horror stories that have been reported in the news. And I thought that this would just kind of be a nice time to get like cozy together, have a snack. So I'll be eating in this because I feel like we're gonna be going over spooky stories that were reported in the news. But to me, that gives slumber party vibes. That's hanging out with your friends, telling scary stories. So I'm in my jammies. I've got my chips and dip here, like it's a slumber party. And I just thought this would be a real fun one for you guys today. So, let's get ourselves nice and comfortable. Grab yourselves a nice glass of water, a big old bowl of Ruffles chips, original, of course. Maybe even some Ruffles. What is this flavor that I got here? Onion.
Porcelain doll, or Annabelle, or Robert, right?
Father. temperatures, he ordered his sons to take shifts and use overwhelming force, but denied that an association with cults, occults, and secret societies played any part in the death. Weird that we went there. After a 4-day jury deliberation, all 7 members were cleared of their charges on March 14th of 2019. I'm shocked, guys. Why? Why were they cleared of their charges? That was so loud. I'll make sure you guys don't cut down the audio. Anyway, that's all we have on that one. I hate that. Gross. Wow. Okay. Also, if I thought my family was like seriously like, I don't know, possessed, I guess, I'd like book them and then maybe book me. But anyway, okay. The next one is dead animals in the walls. When the Brezius family decided to insulate their home in Auburn, Pennsylvania in 2015, they discovered that it already had been with scores of dead animal carcasses. Fox reported that the dead animals were wrapped in newspapers from the 1930s and 40s and were among half-used spices and other items. That's some witchy stuff right there. After removing the items, they'd sent hundreds of artifacts and carcasses to an expert in Coltstown. Okay. The expert attributed the rotting animals in their walls to powwow or Dutch magic. I'm Dutch. Magic. A ritual originating in the culture of the Pennsylvania Dutch to treat ailments and gain physical and spiritual protection. I mean, it's better than anything else, right? The Pennsylvanian Dutch were a group of German-speaking settlers to Pennsylvania in the 1600s to 1700s and are often Lutheran, Mennonite, or of Amish faiths. The Washington Post noted, many of the spells deal with the care of livestock, finding water, or the treatment of minor ailments, reflecting the conditions and concerns of early American settlers. But powwow also has within the tradition darker spells. One notable ritual in their tradition is to hex, to create loyalty in a dog. To attach a dog to a person, providing nothing else was used before to affect it. Try to draw some of your own blood and let the dog eat it along with its food and it'll stay with you. Ew. There was mold found on rotting carcasses in the home and it actually caused illnesses within the family, and they say that the odor still has not gone away. Yeah, that's honestly the first thing I thought is, okay, how is this gonna affect my health? Is this gonna make me sick? Like, ew. messed up. Oh my god. So the police were notified because a friend of one of the students who participated in the rituals raised alarms. However, none of the students themselves told their parents about the event. Yeah. surviving child. Like, oh my goodness. Just to come back to that, you lost everybody and like, ugh. Man, I'm so fat. So, the phone stalker. In 2007, ABC News documented a series of phone calls to family with, to families with specifically terrifying death threats. The unidentified caller knew exactly what the families were doing and even what they were wearing. The family said that the calls came in the house at all hours of the night, threatening to kill their children, their pets, their grandparents. Voicemails arrived, playing records of their private conversations. Said what they were wearing, what they were doing, and after months of investigating, police seemed powerless to stop them. This went on with the Coy-Canal family for months, who reported a caller with a scratchy voice threatening to slit their throats. When the Faircrest, Washington police tried to find the culprit, saying, isn't this so funny? You can see people's cameras. Check it out. And it was like, it was someone's like camera to the road where their garbages are picked up. And I was like, nah, this is messed up. But people have access to that type of thing. Disgusting. Disgusting. Ugh. Horrible. Horrible. Okay. The Watcher. The name of the story. So, after $1.3 million mansion, a New Jersey family started receiving creepy death threats from someone who identified themselves as the Watcher. A CBS News reported earlier this year that since moving in, the owners said that they'd received numerous letters from this mysterious person. The Watcher claimed the home has been the subject and waiting for its second coming. German woman to her home in Tokyo, Japan, broke into her apartment while she was sleeping and attempted to cut out a piece of flesh off of her body to consume. When she awoke, she reportedly fought him, and he was later captured by the police. According to a 2012 Vice documentary that covered his bizarre story, he was mistakenly charged with an attempted rape, and his wealthy father had paid the victim a settlement outside of court so that the charges were dropped. So sure enough, 7 years later, in 1981, he allegedly committed a murder in France, shooting and eating a fellow university student, René Hartveld. Ugh. Essay creepily documented the entire experience with photographs, and he was captured by authorities once again while attempting to dump the rest of her body in the Bois de Boulogne Lake. He was deported back to Japan and committed to a mental institution. However, for reasons unknown, his psychologist state.